Welcome to Stories of Impact. I'm your host, Tavia Gilbert, and along with journalist Richard Sergey, every first and third Tuesday of the month, we share conversations about the art and science of human flourishing. I hope your year is off to a peaceful, productive, energized start. I think today's episode is the perfect conversation to begin our programming in 2023. This is a story of impact that I have been so excited to bring you. It hits me right in the heart, exactly as it should. Let me set the stage for you. Have you ever been in a group of people, everyone focused on the same thing, a sports competition or a sermon or a performance, and you've had a feeling that you're being transported or transformed by what you're experiencing? It's when you've been a part of a collective moment of being that is so powerful and so meaningful that you forget about any self-consciousness or shyness or hesitation, and you feel swept up in what might be called celebration or rapture or joy or love. I think many of us have had this delicious, positively consuming feeling before. Maybe watching the World Cup or a presidential inauguration celebration or a holiday church service. There's actually a term for those beautiful, resonant, collective experiences, occasions that can feel almost spiritual. It's called collective effervescence. And today we are exploring the collective effervescence of Koolulam, a social musical initiative aimed at strengthening the fabric of society, centering around mass singing events. Mass singing, I love this so much. As a member of choirs for decades and someone whose entire professional career has focused on the voice, I love the idea of Koolulam. Group singing with the intention to inspire peace and spread love, and I'm so excited to bring it to you today. Let's start with Michal Shahaf, CEO and co-founder of Koolulam, to tell us what exactly Koolulam is and how it works.
What we do actually is that we bring sometimes hundreds, sometimes thousands, and sometimes tens of thousands of people that has no background in music. And in less than an hour, we teach them a new arrangement of a well-known song. And after 45 minutes of teaching each group with its own part of the vocals, we do the final performance of everyone together. We film it, we record it, and we distribute it online. We did hundreds of events until today, actually all around the world. And our videos have their own life on social media.
Musician Ben Yaffet, along with his co-founders Michal Shahaf and Taicher, had the courage to innovate the creation of a group singing event unlike any concert ever experienced before. As Koolulam musical director and conductor, Yaffet was responsible for two key aspects of the experience.
The first is actually technical, to make sure that this song is available and accessible for people that they are non-musicians and they are non-singers, which is how the ranges go, if it's too complicated or not. And the second thing, which is actually the more important thing, is what the meaning of this song or what we are aiming to bring with this event, the message that we want to bring with this event. The miracle that Koolulam does is to bring a lot of people that are non-musicians to sing together with different vocal parts, which will take like 2 weeks for most choirs to do. And they're gonna do that in half an hour. They're gonna learn this song in half an hour, 45 minutes. And the reason that it's happening is because they had to go out from their comfort zone, to be very alert, to be very present in the moment. That's what we are trying to do with them, with us, and to learn something that they understand they need each other to succeed, to have a big goal that they need to be very alert to get into together.
And the result of that intense focus and presence, learning the song in just 45 minutes? Truly beautiful music.
When you take 3,000 people that don't know to sing and probably singing out of tone most of their lives, right? Like me, yeah? I'm one of them. When you bring them together and they're singing together, suddenly it sounds like this beautiful harmony. How can it be? How can it be? Each one of us alone is not something you want to listen to. And the thing is that when we are doing it together, when we are part as a group learning and performing it together, we must listen and be aligned with each other. And this is what makes it sound like this beautiful harmony.
Why did transcendent mass singing events come into being? Filmmaker and Koolulam Artistic and Creative Director, or Taicher, first came up with the idea.
My inspiration, first of all, is people. I'm living in my country. I felt in those times that the social dialogue was really violent. I felt that everybody can push their agenda without consider the people that we are surround and without any sensitive to our environment around us and the people in the society around us. One time I got a video clip of 100,000 people standing in front of the Western Wall in Jerusalem, the holy place for the Jewish people, one of the holy places. And I remember saw these people and they all stand there, men, women, all colors, all ages, and they prayer in Hebrew, they said, Chatanu lefanecha. It means, please, God, forgive me for my sins. And I thought to myself, wow. Like, this is all the people that I see fighting on social media, on street, pushing each other on the line for the supermarket. But in one night, they all stand there and pray together like hoping for a better future. And I felt the hope. I saw this and I asked myself, what if we'll take this religious prayer? And what if we will do it as a social prayer? Then I had a question. If a musical harmony can create harmony in humanity. And I didn't understand in the first minute what I'm trying to do. But I had a really deep feeling that this activity can change people's perspective, can change people, can open people's heart. So maybe in that way we will start to open our perspective and maybe inspiration will fill, you know, our mind and our soul. I understand that a good idea is not enough. I need the right people with me to create this vision. I met Ben after I met 12 conductors that told me that this is the most stupid idea that they ever heard. How we can teach thousands of people to sing a song in 3 vocals in less than 45 minutes? Never can happen. Oh, and another thing I heard, oh, this is boring, nobody will come to this. Michal, Ben, and I started to build this vision, what everybody knows today as Koolulam.
Entrepreneur and digital strategy expert Shahaf took on the Koolulam project because she wanted to use her talents and business experience to make a positive impact in her nation and around the globe.
There wasn't a specific inspiration. There was more a very violent dialogue in the society that made us all understand that something needs to be changed in Israel. But not only. We get hundreds of emails from people all across the globe. Everyone writes the same words, which is, we feel that our people are separated, there are a lot of violence, we need something that connect people, to remind people the things that connect us. It doesn't matter who we are, what we do, who we go to sleep with at night, all that matter that we want to reconnect. And we really feel privileged to provide this platform for a lot of countries. But first, we provided it here in Israel. People want to be part of something that is bigger than themselves. People want to be part of a group, part of a mission, want to bring their voice to a group, want to be active. People want to be active.
They needed to call themselves something. So where did Koolulam come from?
Koolulu in Arabic means ululation. Ululation like happiness. And in Hebrew, the word kulam is everyone. So it's like ululation for everyone, which is Koolulam. And inside the word Koolulam, there are a few hidden words also, which is kol in Hebrew, which is voice, and olam, which is world. So everything together connects to it. But the idea is that actually the word doesn't mean anything because we want to create like a new language of singing together.
So with the idea, a team, and the name, how exactly did these social mass singing innovators begin to realize their vision?
We knew that we want to do a coexistent event, and we got approached from an NGO in Haifa. And Haifa in Israel is one of the most combined cities, you know. And we thought, what will be the right song for this kind of event, you know? For this coexistence event, you need something that is very, very delicate. So we invited 3,000 Muslims, Christians, and Jews to sing together the song One Day by Matisseau in Hebrew, English, and Arabic. One Day is one of the most monumental, inspirational events of Koolulam.
The founder's dream was big. It was audacious. It was bold. What would actually happen? No one quite knew.
If we want that this event will happen, it's death or life. Yeah, sure, bring Muslim, Christian, Jews. No problem, no worries. Oh God. This is felt like mission impossible. I didn't saw a different reality. I understand that we have to do it. I understand deeply inside me that this event will be the game changer of Koolulam. This event can show the world that we can do it differently.
The team made a music video documenting the February 2018 event, and the video is as inspirational and beautifully produced as the events themselves. We'll link to the video in the show notes, but for now, let me share what I saw in the viral video of that inaugural Koolulam experience with 3,000 people singing Matisyahu's song One Day. The 5-minute music video opens over Haifa, then pans to people on the street, in transit, on their way to the performance space, and then the camera snaps to conductor Ben Yaffet. He spreads his arms wide as he invites all the participants, children on their parents' shoulders, old men, young women, Christians, Jews, Muslims, together to sing. Evocative lights sweep over the darkened performance space, illuminating the faces of the singers. They close their eyes and hold their hands over their heart, move with the music, and raise their faces to the sky as if to offer the song to the heavens. They grin at each other, lean into each other, put their arms around each other's shoulders, then jump with the beat of the drums. And an ecstatic and confident Yaffet, flanked by live musicians, jumps too, his mouth stretched wide as he sings along. It is so ecstatic that you don't have to be there to feel the irresistible, joyful, heart-expanding energy. But this video makes you want to be there, to be even more connected to the collective effervescence of this magical, transformative mass singing experience. Yaffet describes the transformation that happens for the people who come together to create the experience.
What we are doing is to create an environment for a specific time that you can understand the power of us, of our community, together. When you are in a Koolulam event, from the beginning you come like a stranger, but then because you did something with so many people, it's like to go on a trip and you go with a lot of people that you don't know. But in some point, because you helped each other to get to the point that everyone wants to get into, you feel like you are connected. And when we take this music, which have the power, the active power, to practice this listening, this attention to each other, this is about us connecting and creating something bigger than us. And the power when we are connected is just crazy.
Yaffet experienced the power of collective effervescence at the very first event, when he saw what was happening among the participants. Maybe that's how Koolulam's motto, singing is believing, came to life.
There is some very, very big power of music to connect people together. So in some point, when I looked to the right, I saw three women. One was with a cover in her head, the other one had hijab, and the other one was so secular from Tel Aviv, having good time. And they all sang together. One day this always change, treat people the same, stop with the violence, down with the hate, stop. And when I look at them, when we did these rehearsals, I was like, oh my God, what is happening right now? And listen, I'm not a politician, but I think that the big changes always coming from the people, from the ground, from people that sincerely really want a significant change. And when I saw this event, I said, I think like we have hope and we have to generate this to every place that we can get into. At the end, everybody wants the same, wants to feel loved, wants to feel accepted, wants to feel that they have the place for them to be. And what? Like this is, let's get loud. We have to be enough brave to be vulnerable and honest. I don't know how to say that. Like, it's like a trip in yourself about screaming yourself out, not really screaming, just the message got so loud. And it was a magical event.
Koolulam launched with the one-day video getting 7 million views. And it was just what Shahaf and her co-founders had hoped for.
We want to inspire also people around the world that will be able to see this kind of thing, that will see 3,000 Muslim Jews and Christians singing together. And we know it will inspire them because of the effect that it did around the world. It got into World Radio Day and played in 2,000 radio stations around the world. This was the first event that also opened the gates of Koolulam to the rest of the world.
Koolulam grew from there.
We started from 550 participants and then got bigger and bigger.